Okay, so I hope all of you have downloaded the Bayer Act or get the Bayer Act. Please bring the Bayer Act. Now, which Bayer Act to buy? I prefer Taxman because it's good. Anyway, there are many publishers. Go with the most reasonable one. There's no point in simply spending money. There's hardbound, which costs more just for the binding as such. And do I need to buy with the rules or without the rules? What do you think? This is what I have got. Do I have to buy with the rules or without the rules? Your wish. Without the rules should be fine. Rules keep changing. That's the reason. The basic set of rules are already there, but they keep adding on, and you know, so that sense of the term, you may want to just stick with the normal one. If you have some extra money, if you would want to buy the rules, I'm cool with it. And all the more, it's a little more bulkier. On the other hand, if you just buy the normal act, it will be a small one. I think you have that book, no? It's a small one. So that's how it is. And since there have been quite a few changes, including the amendment, the ordinance rather, so it's better to buy the new one. Even 1 or 2 years old has already become outdated. So we need to buy the new law. And as far as the this thing is concerned, what do you say, the app? There are quite a few apps. One, which is the one you told me? Company, some CA Club, it seems. That is also good. I just saw. MMJC Advisory is also decent. They're all free apps. So, free publicity for those guys now. But it's good. It's good. It's free and it works. And they have updated stuff. But I would always prefer the hard copy because you can underline, you can. It's up to you. Totally your call. But without the Bayer Act, that's the textbook, honestly speaking. The material that I've given you is just supplementary. It will definitely, that is the material for your exams, no doubt about it. But it has been designed in such a way that if you do not attend classes, then you cannot read that material. So you need to attend the classes. And I told you that I'll be giving you the video classes as well. Because of that, don't bunk classes. That is one idea. Anyway, this fellow will give no. Aram Sai will bang no. Because the discussion, I always believe that yes, video will reach a far greater, wider audience, but nothing can beat face-to-face interaction. Nothing can ever beat face-to-face interaction because you guys are here, you are asking your doubts live. So please never ever miss my classes. It's very, very important, honestly, because if I do a section today, 10 days later, I'll be connecting it. So when I will tell, okay, that day we discussed, right? You will be wondering, that day did I come or not? So first of all, so that should not be there. So please come. It's 3 hours a day. I'm giving you Sunday off also, right? So last few Sundays, we'll see. The methodology I'll be discussing now. Cool. So first and foremost, first question, guys, tell me, when should I study law? Morning, evening, when? Any idea? Take a discussion. Tell me, when to study? Morning, evening? Honestly, it's the most stupid question that generally we ask our seniors, when to study. It is up to you. Because I am a night person. They used to call me owl. In Kannada, it's called gube. They used to call me gube only. Because why? I never used to sleep. 2 a.m. you message me, I'm there. 3 a.m. message me, I'm there. 4 a.m. I'm there. Today I had class, yesterday 4 a.m. Simply some random student of mine sent good morning message. I said good morning. Imagine. So the thing is, that's how it is. So I like to study at night. Morning is very groggy for me. You guys may be a morning person. I don't know. Morning is fine. I made the mistake. See, whatever mistakes I made, I don't want you to do the same. I made the mistake of asking this to my seniors. Some of them were rank holders. So one rank holder said morning. One more rank holder said evening. So I did the average and studied in the afternoon. Correct? So that shouldn't be the case. We need to obviously fix the time according to you. If you feel that you can grasp better in the morning, your wish. It's totally your wish. Second one, how many hours to study? Here again, you can't say it's a very stupid question and all that. This is not. How many hours, right? How many hours? Any idea, guys? You will be accustomed to slowly get accustomed to my amazing handwriting. This is the main reason why I cleared in the first attempt. because they couldn't understand anything. They saw this fellow, if I fail him, he'll again come back to me only. That's what every evaluator thought. I said, pass. That's the key to have to clear in the first interview. Anyway, so how many asked to study, guys? Any idea? We can't blindly say 3 hours, 4 hours, 2 hours and all that. One thing, I don't know if you have done it. I'll be very happy if you have done it. Have you, measured your study speed per hour? 90% of them would not have done it. Same thing I also didn't do during my final or couple of months before I realized. Not reading speed per hour, novel reading, all that, no. Bangalore Times reading, all that is like 5 minutes. I'm talking about study speed. Have you measured? How much is yours? Approx. Brilliant. 7 to 8 is actually very good, man, actually. 7 to 8 is the, 6 is the average. I'm talking about study speed. So it's very simple. How many hours to study depends on the number of pages to study. Right now, if my target for the day is 16, and it all boils down to my study speed per hour. If my study speed per hour is 6, then I'll take around 2.5 hours. If it's around 8, I'll just take 2 hours. If it is, mine was 3 to 4, I'm not kidding. If it is 4, I'll take the same, how many? 4 hours to do the same damn thing. You can do it in 2 hours, I'll take 4 hours. Now, that's the only thing I have to do. I have to spend 4 hours to study 16 pages, which you would have taken 2 hours. So, kindly measure the study speed per hour on priority. If it is 3 to 4, please do not worry, even minus 3 to 4, and I'm standing before you, sitting rather before you as a CA, even you can become. 6 is the average, 7 to 8 is brilliant actually, 10 is like, you know, rank holder material, nothing like that, just kidding, but it is up to you. Now, how to measure this? You just start studying and you ask your friend, your mom, your dad, or whoever to measure, because if you start measuring, what will you do? Oh, 10 minutes to go, 2 pages. No. So you just forget that you've told your mom and you aram se coolly start studying without even seeing the time. Then at the end of 1 hour, they should come and tell you. Then you just count the pages. It's okay. Now, minus 3 to 4, can I drastically change it to 7 to 8 in 2-3 months? Impossible. Even now it is 3 to 4 for me. Novel, I'll read quickly. Study, I'll get lost in the subject. I'll sit and connect some 1,000 things. That's the problem. Always been the problem. So, I cannot do it in 3 to 4 months. So, the only way is to slowly try and increase the speed. Slowly. It's not possible to do it in 3 to 4 months because you've been accustomed to studying 3 to 4 pages all your life and suddenly to change, not possible. So, we should not compare with our friends and try to goof up our own thing. So, how many hours to study? It totally depends on you. The third one is, of course, how do I study law? I am talking about company law now. How do I study this? What is the methodology? It all depends on the keyword analysis. So, we'll be doing a lot of keywords. So, our methodologies will be doing a lot of, keyword analysis. Like when we are reading the Bera, that's why I prefer a book, because you can underline stuff there. You can make notes. And that apparently that other app has that provision of making notes, right? So, which is that company, CA Club, something, CA Club. Anyway, but I would prefer, if you are a, tech person who would always be on your phone and would like to do that, please go ahead. But I would prefer a book, your wish. But ultimately, please download an offline app, because there's no, network here. So, offline app is always better. So, we'll be doing a lot of keyword analysis. There are so many differences between shall, may, all that we'll be discussing. And of course, three things that I have spoken to almost around 48 to 50 rank holders. Most of them happen to be my friends. And three things, see, some studied, how many subjects per day to study? That also varies, right? You cannot ask people like that. You may be comfortable with one subject a day. Some will be comfortable with two subjects a day. One rank holder friend of mine studied 8 subjects a day, mad fellow. 1 1 hour, 1 1 subject. He actually did it. He got All India's 5th rank. So you can't ask those questions. But one thing the common thread that I, when I spoke to these guys, the common thing during these days, I'll also request my friend CA Shruti, I'll request her to come and talk to you guys. She has scored IPCC All India rank 1 and CA final rank 3. And rank 3, why? I'll tell you her story some other day. She was supposed to score rank 1, but something happened. Yeah, so if you see those three, I'll come ask her to come and speak to you guys. One of these days we'll do it. So yeah, three things, common things that all these rank holders, the basic that I could figure out. The methodology is different, the number of hours is different, everything is different. But the three things, number one thing is all of them prepared something called as running notes. So you were asking me during the break. So running notes. What are running notes? So you need to prepare something called as running notes. So when we are discussing now, you need to note down all the points that when we start the law, all the points that you feel. Tell me one thing. My textbook, it's an open statement recorded on video. My notes is a sheer waste one day before the exam. The Bayer Act is a sheer waste one day before the exam. Any textbook is a sheer waste one day before the exam. What is going to save you? Your running notes. Because think about it, you have a couple of textbooks, think about it. One day before the exam is the real deal. You have the Bayer Act here, you have my material, you have my three modules, you have some you know, textbook from some author, two textbooks, your CA Institute material, practice manual. Have you come for a South Indian meal? You know, all removing all those cups and keeping? No. Correct. The only thing that really matters is your running notes. All the pointers, all the stuff. I will also tell you how to prepare the running notes, part of which I have given. So that's the thing. Running notes is the key. Once you maintain your running notes, other things are sorted. How to maintain, I'll definitely tell you, don't worry. So whatever is discussed, jot down, and you need to keep revising. Can I revise everything every day? No. That day's portion, if you can study that day, it will be great. And it is possible. Today anyway was like the basics, but going forward from tomorrow, that day's portion should be revised that day. Sunday can be a revision day. 1 hour, 2 hours, you take off. We'll plan it out aram se. Sunday you chill. Then Sunday will be the revision day, where you revise everything that happened that week. Second Sunday, whatever happened first week and second week. Got it? So my intention is when you are studying, company law should be the least of your problems after the classes are over. That should be the least of your problems. So you will only have 7 subjects to study. Plus I'll give you the video. Whenever you have the doubts, you can check it out. Right? Why simply come again and waste time? Again, one, like in 6 months, you'll forget everything. So you will come again 150 hours and waste. No, I don't want you to waste your time. If you still want to come, please come. But what I'm saying is, there's no point. I'll give you the video. You can aramse check it out at home. Cool. So that is the second part. Yeah. Then one, the three common threads. Everybody writes. We need to write answers. We need to write answers. And how am I going to help? We will be having at least 3 to 4 full-fledged examinations, right? One of the, like maybe Saturday, full-fledged examinations. I'm not talking about 20 mark, 30 mark, 100 mark exams. Like for example, if I do 2 concepts, 2 chapters, those 2 chapters based on that 100 marks, which means everything in that will come. So like that we'll have 3 to 4. I've already prepared the papers also, papers are also ready. Or maybe on Sunday I can give you home, you can give it, you can write at home. Or one of those Sundays you can come here and write in an examination environment. You can come here and aram se write, no problem. So that is one thing. We need to write. Writing is essential. Without writing, it's not possible. These theory papers, so-called theory papers like audit, law, etc., we need to write and practice. So coming to writing, like for example, if I have to write a 4-marker, how much time should I spend, guys? Any idea on writing 4 marks? Yes, it's the standard calculation. We have 180 minutes and 100 marks. Very, very simple it is. So basically it is 1.8 minutes per mark. As simple as that. 4 marks is 4 into 1.8, 7.2 minutes. That's it. And in fact, in 180 minutes also, I can remove 20 minutes where we would be, when we do a SWOT analysis, we have strength, weakness, opportunity, and a threat. Now, that threat, 20 minutes, I can exclude. What is a threat, by the way? You are sitting in a examination hall which has no electricity. And all your mock exams are in the AC environment. Happens. That's a threat. Actually, think about it. And you have written your mock exam in complete isolation and silence. There in your examination hall, beside that road, there's a wedding going on. Possible. You can't control that. Horse, bloody horse is there. Horse is not moving only. And they're all dancing in front of the horse. That's it. Think about it. Think about it, guys. I did not clear exam because of a wedding. Sounds so stupid, right? To yourself. Forget about others. We are attuned to in this isolated environment, absolutely no sound, and suddenly that is thrust on us. So 20 minutes you remove. So I can keep it 1.6 minutes per mark, 6.4 minutes. So when we write the answers, we need to, you know, time ourselves initially. You will never be able to do it in 6.4 minutes, I can assure you, initially. Later, slowly, it will come. Definitely, it will come. Don't worry, guys. So we need to write the answers. Third most important is the mock exam, which anyway, I'm covering it. No problem. 3-4 exams you're writing. But this mock exam is what? Before the exam. That also we need to write. Your institute has no ICAI exam. You go write that. No problem. Mock exam. I've spoken to all rank holders. Trust me, all rank holders have followed these 3 points. And in that 48 that I spoke to, 41 people have failed in the mock exam. I am not kidding. They have failed in the mock exam 20 days before the actual exam in which they got All India rank. Which means they realize that all of a sudden when I'm writing, I actually cannot think of everything and write it at one shot. So then they wrote one more mock exam after coming home, one more in the next few days. So 2 mock exams ideally per subject, ideally. So these are the 3 things that we have to clearly take into consideration. Now, next point is, what do I write? I say I write. There's this one saying, right? An apple a day keeps the doctor away. My saying, an answer a day keeps 6 months away. Correct? If you know what I mean. So every single day we need to write one answer. And I am here, you can come and show it to me. I will evaluate for you, no problem. Or you can send me, WhatsApp me the picture. I can just check it out and see where probably you're going wrong and all those things. So 3 things are there where we need to, when I have to write the answers, how will I write? One is provisions of law. I'm going to show you the papers as well. Provisions of law. Then I have to write the analysis. And finally, I'm going to write the conclusion. Provisions, analysis, conclusion. Now, I'm going to, in the provisions, tell me, guys, should I remember section number and write? What do you think? We are in CA final level. What do you think? What do you feel? 100% yes. If you open the institute material, first page only, what do they say? What is the level expected? Expert level. Means you have to actually do that expert level only. They expect you to do it. No doubt about it. Can I write by mistake? Wrong section number and all. Can I write? Definitely not. So one of my students, I'll just show you. This is, he had written auditing and he showed me. So if you see this, guys. What has he done? Some schedule number, he has made it wrong. So you see, no mercy, absolutely no mercy. You cannot write the wrong part number, schedule number and all that. That should be absolutely clear. Then one more, let's see. So they will not show you any mercy, by the way. If you are wrong, you are wrong. There is no second thought about it. See, this I showed you. This was one more, I think. Somewhere else it comes. See here also. Clause 5. Wrong clause number. Gone. Zero mercy. Your content is correct. clause number is wrong, will they give you half mark? No, zero. One of my students in November 17, that dreaded paper, the All India rank one guy, I think, got around 54 in law. All India rank 2, 100 in SFM. How can you get 100? I really don't understand. 100 in, it's not business studies, no, to get 100. Right? How can you get 100 in SFM, man? Crazy guy. 100 he got in SFM. At least for, like, you know, for TDS, 1 or 2 marks you have to deduct. Crazy. That also, that guy also got around 57 in law. My student, Bal Krishna, I'm very proud of him. 67 marks he scored in that same paper. Probably one of the highest in law. You just see. I will share this paper also. I never asked him to, but he was sweet enough to get this on his own. He extracted the paper and, you know, gave it to me. See the question. Any question, check it out. He first has written the provisions, the correct section number, right? Then brief about the provision. This is the brief about the provision. So according to section 164, directors of company so and so not filed, whatever, brief about the provision. So he has, should you underline, should you write it in paragraphs or should I write it in points? If possible, points or paragraphs also fine, but you need to underline wherever you feel it is important. That doesn't mean we underline everything because we feel everything is important. Whatever the keywords you feel, you will get to know slowly. So whatever, when we get to know slowly, you just have to underline the important points because they'll evaluate that way. Then finally, we have this again, the analysis of the case and the conclusion. See, the first answer itself, 4 out of 4. So one more very important thing for us to understand, honestly speaking, is this. Any idea who evaluates our papers? These are all important areas. Who evaluates? CAs. CAs evaluate. Really? Can BCom, your teacher, BCom teacher who hated you because you are doing CA, he couldn't do it. He hated you. Can he evaluate? What do you think, guys? Yes. If you go to ICAI empanelment of evaluators, etc., we see the criteria, CA, CS, SWA, MBA graduates with some experience, BCom graduates, BCom lecturers with some years of experience can evaluate. So the guy who hated you for doing CA can end up becoming an evaluator. So tell me, will they have, and one more thing, tell me, any idea what's the payment? They are evaluating a CA paper. One paper which you have slogged for 6 months and you have written for 3 hours. If I want to evaluate properly, 20 to 30 minutes it actually takes properly. Any idea what's the rate per paper or per hour? Per paper. What's the rate? It was 60 bucks before. Now after all fighting, because they say, for example, institute charges prospectus fee from students. What is the prospectus? PDF that you download. I'm not kidding. For that, 100 rupees they charge. If 2 lakh CPT students join, 2 lakh into 100, it's their revenue from a PDF file. How much do they pay? 110 rupees. That's all per paper. Per paper. So, which CA in his right mind, think about it, would want to evaluate? Because he will evaluate only two papers an hour. 220 rupees per hour, CA. For his client, he bills for his article clerk only higher. Correct, no? So if you see, nobody would want this. So generally, there's a trend where CAs, I would love to evaluate, but I can't. Why? Yeah, anybody who is in the faculty pool of ICAI can never evaluate. Conflict of interest, okay, fair enough. But it goes to some random fellows, random CA, good chartered accountants, no doubt about it, who would want to evaluate. But they will, is there an evaluation center? No. It will go to their respective home. So that person would have fought with the spouse, and after all the day's work, then he'll open the paper. These are all very important for you to understand. Tell me, how much time will he give you? I have seen people who evaluate, they just give 10 minutes. I'm not kidding. They just give 10 minutes. which means your entire 6 months effort and that 3 hours that you write. Honestly, 6 months effort, 8 papers into 3 hours is 24 hours. And your correction is 8 papers into 10 minutes, 80 minutes. You walk into John Wick 3. By the time you come out, they'll tell you whether you're a CA or not. All the papers will be evaluated. That's how crazy it is. 10 minutes, that's it guys. 10 minutes per paper. As simple as that. So these are the hard facts of life, which means they will give you just 10 minutes to impress. Tell me guys, first answer only if you have written B.S. Raman style. B.S. Raman was brilliant for PUC. Brilliant. Can you use that style for CA? In simple words, in other words, in active voice, in passive voice, in some other voice, next inner voice. Right? No. Crisp to the point. I will share this paper, Bal Krishna's paper. Please go through. And you have the first 4 minutes to impress the hell out of the evaluator. When he or she is evaluating, like, wow, I am getting inferiority complex. Brilliant. First 4 minutes, you impress, later you write whatever you want. When I say whatever you want, obviously, here and there, it's not very good. He has also done the same thing. See, 4 out of 4. 3 out of 4. 3 out of 4. 4 out of 4. 3 out of 4. First 44 minutes is like 40 marks. 40 marks is floored him. He's literally floored the evaluator. Later, here and there, the allied laws, economic laws, whatever you do, guys, you can't write proper answers. Let's be honest. That you cannot write amazing answers in that. He has also written very substandard, not very decent. Okay, answers. And have they given marks? Yes, they have given marks. So, it's just a mind game. Do you watch Suits? Yeah? Don't play the odds, play the man. I have it there also in the board, right? So, you need to play the man. As simple as that. So don't play the odds at all. Play the man. Who's the man? The person evaluating. You have to play him. It's actually you have to play him. Play him in the sense he's also a human being, right? So that is what you need to do. So this is most important, guys. We really, really, really need to ensure that provision analysis conclusion is there. So slowly during the course of our classes, we'll understand how to do that provision analysis conclusion. So, I have shown you the papers and all that, that's how it is. Section number, wrong section number is disastrous for us to write. So, all our answers should be provisions, analysis and conclusion. Analysis and conclusion go hand in hand. Handwriting, does it matter? No, definitely not. You just have to be, it has to be little legible. Should be able to read. It's not that a doctor has written it, right? You should just be able to read it. And do I need to embellish my answer with some sketch pen, highlighter? No. You don't have time. Scale? No. Writing scale, putting all line everywhere, double line? No. Just whatever you are writing, just, yeah, you've seen that guy, no? Just wherever he felt like, he just underlined, see? He just underlined here only, wherever. But he's written section number everywhere. So, one of my IPCC students as well, 71 she scored. Okay, IPCC final, you can't say, okay, the level is, I understand. But see, the writing, the answers, 4 out of 4, then 5 out of 5 here, then again 5 out of 5, 4 out of 4. Everybody you see, same thing, same, see, underline wherever is needed. First 40 marks, impress the hell out of the evaluator. He should give you like, for 45 marks, he should give you 40. Remaining 55 marks, can't we score 20? Yes. So let's not be greedy and tell we'll score 90, 95. It is not possible in law. I am not giving you false hopes here by telling 95 you can score. It's not possible. It is humanly impossible. So we should be practical enough to score around 65, 70. 70 plus is like amazing. 65 plus, anything 65 plus is amazing. Should be practical. Rational rather than being foolish and tell we can score 90 and all those things. So that's the deal. This is the basic. Coming to my notes, 5 minutes I'll take, then we'll stop. Tomorrow we can start with a wonderful section. I'll come to that basic where I'm planning to do here. So first, coming to the notes, how it is planned. As I told you, after analysis of almost past 10-15 attempts, I have divided everything into clusters. Believe it or not, they are dividing. Who are the paper setters? Generally, they are company secretaries. Generally, they are company secretaries whose experience is your age. Minimum 30, actually more than that, more than your age, 30, 35, 40 years experience. They breathe, eat company law. They know in and out of the law. So they set the paper. And as far as I have observed, this is a trend in the last almost 10, 15 papers. They give questions based on clusters. So what I have done is divided the entire subject into clusters. So cluster one will be all these sections. From this, will one question come guaranteed? Yes. Divide and rule policy, what the British used. We'll divide the entire company law paper and then rule over each cluster, an overall paper. Cluster two, cluster three, like that. See, cluster five is your appointment of auditor, duties and responsibilities of auditor, accounts of the company. This is there where in audit and old syllabus law, it's there. Old syllabus law, they have it law also, they have it in audit also. New syllabus, they have removed it from law, but it is still there in audit. Correct? So this part also I will be doing in depth because we need it for other areas. Okay? So when I say in depth, I'm not going to do the reporting requirements and all in depth. But the appointment provisions, your NFRA, interlink, consequence provisions, all that we have to do. So I will be covering a little bit of auditing as well, right? No extra fees. I'm just kidding. No fee. But yeah, this we have to do, guys. Though it is there, though it's not there for you, it definitely comes in auditing. And nobody here is sitting who has got exemption in auditing and sitting here for law. Correct? So you have to study auditing anyway. So anyway, we'll do that. It's covered in the thing. We'll do it. So that's the thing. And you see one question. I told you 10 marks from IBC. Producer company, one question. Producer company, many trainers also don't do it only. 4 marks will come generally. In the past 28 attempts, 26 attempts, I've asked 4 marks. So like that. So there are 14 clusters that I've made. And all clusters need a very, very important chapter called Interpretation of Statutes, which they have coolly deleted from new syllabus. Why have they deleted from new syllabus? They have added it in IPCC new syllabus. Now, you guys are IPCC old or new? Old. That's the most unfortunate part. You are IPCC old, CA final new. But this is the most important chapter in my view. If you don't understand how to interpret the statute, how will you interpret law? Correct? So, as and when the class is going on, as and when we interpret each and every line, I'll be using interpretation of statutes and explaining that to you. Old syllabus, couple of you are there, bumper. This will come for 4 marks, guaranteed. 100% question. That is a separate question on interpretation of statute. But new syllabus, no separate question. But without understanding that, everything else is a waste. So that extra we have to do, no problem. Aram 7, we are doing the law only, we'll do it. So these are all the various clusters. Now, if you see the marks also, I've divided only till 12. I'll add the other three clusters. So these are all the general marks, 4, 10 is the thing. So it's like crazy. They regularly ask this. Now, I've given you how to use this book. As I told you, it's just supplementary and an addition to the classroom, but it's definitely not a replacement. Most important material is the Bayer Act. So you can go through the how to study. You should concentrate and maintain running notes. Then you can study along with it. Sundays can be kept for revision. And this handout plus any compiler you can pick out. I'll also give you questions. If in the last part, you have the questions for these clusters. So this notes, how many clusters it has? I have given only 4 clusters. Module 1 has only 4 clusters. Heavy duty areas, very, very important areas. Plus, I've given a question bank. This is from page 158 to 187. All the questions, previous year's questions, we'll be solving each and every question. Right? Each and every question I'll be solving. And the last 4-5 attempts, I will put up the actual papers as well on the screen. We can solve that, and I'll send you the papers. You can. I feel some you have to do paper wise also. Open the paper and see what are the questions that they have been asking. So that's the deal. Now I'll take 2 more minutes of your thing, of your time. So first, if you see this, you can leave. This is your format of the important resolutions. I'll come to it. Then a little bit on the running notes. What I have done is I've compiled for you the various important case laws and all that, just generally like this, just for your knowledge. Operation mismanagement, winding up. It's like one day before the exam, you can just go through all the important cases which are there. Huh. There are certain things which require only ordinary resolution. That is compiled in page 23. These are all the sections which require only ordinary resolution. What is ordinary resolution? Everything we'll do tomorrow. Tomorrow is the basics of the basics class in understanding the interpretation of law. Then matters requiring special resolution, we will see here. Ordinary, special, all that. Then matters requiring postal at all. This is just for your revision. Revision requirements, all these pages are there. All the penalties, this time some 10 marks they asked penalty, day before yesterday exam. They asked you penalty clauses. Now you also have MCQ. So I'll also be giving you an MCQ booklet, which has around 2000 questions only. So you can solve that. So it's a compilation of around 2000 questions. You can solve that, no problem. I will give it to you. So you have that for how many marks? 30. So good. So all these things will come here, and then all the forms, etc. Now the last part of the day is page number 52. You need to obviously understand the weightage, percentage wise. Otherwise, there's no point. Page number 52. What's the weightage, guys? This is a new syllabus. Old syllabus slightly different. New syllabus. See the weightage. Corporate laws, how many marks? 70 marks. They have also given section wise weightage as well. So the clusters are divided like this only. So nothing to worry. So 30 to 35% from the director's portion, that is almost around 20-25 marks. Then from inspection, inquiry, compromise arrangement, winding up, producer company, see all these things. Then section B is security law and economic laws. So there, if you see SCRA and SEBI, just around, this is the remaining 30 marks. The remaining 30 marks, around 15% to 20%, which is some 6 to 7 marks comes from what? SEBI, right? Then FEMA also 2030, PMLA, see this IBC, Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code, around 30%. That's around 8 to 10 marks will come from IBC. That's how it is. PMLA, then foreign contract, FCRA. These two are not there in the old syllabus, that's all. Foreign Contribution Regulation Act, Arbitration and Conciliation Act, very easy laws, 9 marks, 8 to 10 marks from that, very easy. So this is how we are going to do it. And they have given one more, guys, in page 53, there is one more recently added by the CA Institute, skill-wise percentage. So if you see, they have divided it into skills, comprehension and knowledge, analysis and application, evaluation and synthesis. And if you see here in company law, 30 to 35% is evaluation and synthesis. This is nothing but you are already a CA. I am a client. I am coming to you with a very, very practical doubt. Please solve. That is called evaluation and synthesis. I am giving you a scenario. Analyze the scenario and answer. 30 to 35% of 70%, which is how much? 25 marks will come like that. MCQ and all will be this, no? Comprehension and knowledge. You understand, you know, and you write. So 30 marks will be like that. So what it means also they have given. So when they use the word state, define, normal stuff, MCQ, that will be comprehension and knowledge. Analysis and application, they'll give you prepare, apply, examine, that's okay. But this is the real deed. Integration of data and information, detailed analysis. So 25 marks in your paper is as if you are already a chartered accountant. That's why I feel that the new syllabus is amazing. You guys I am one generation behind you. You guys will be far more superior than we could ever be after clearing CA. And you will be a global chartered accountant. We are Indian chartered accountants. So unless we upgrade and match up to your level, you already have a head start with the syllabus. When I did it, May 12 was my attempt. It was really not so tricky. I'm not kidding. It was tricky, but not like this. I'm not trying to scare you, but it is tricky. No problem. We are doing the bare act methodology line by line. So we will stop here, guys. Tomorrow, we will do a very, very, very important section. That's the mother section of Companies Act. You will really enjoy it. And I will tell you how to read the bare act. It will be great if you could just buy it today. Or you can probably search and download the thing, no problem. Or buy it, your wish. I am not here to force you. I would prefer a hard copy because you can underline. But if you prefer a soft copy, I have absolutely no problem. But one thing for sure, each and every person here should have a bare act. Either the e-form or the actual hard copy. Thank you so much, guys. I hope you had fun. I had fun, first class. Tomorrow onwards, we'll really start. 6:30 sharp, I'm starting. Alright, thank you so much. Have a nice day. You can go around and tell your boss that this fellow took till 10 o'clock. No problem. See you. Bye.